From trails and rivers to horses and trains, the ever-changing frontier posed a multitude of challenges and opportunities.
Writer and producer from Oklahoma. My grandparents had a traveling tent show that followed the wheat harvest through the state. From 1907 to 1929, Oklahoma was one of the fastest growing states in the Union, with a booming economy that was powered by oil and agriculture. In this gallery, you will see how business pioneers added value to the rich resources.
Out of the window, you can see downtown Oklahoma City. Cool. Now, 25 years ago, when the state capital was relocated, 64,000 people. Today, powered by oil and agriculture, the population is over 200,000.
From 1907 to 1929, Oklahoma was one of the fastest growing states.
Snapshots of an era when businessmen and women invested in art and communities.
finds it, but he does not ask for the sale.
Thank you. Unless traveling as a group, middle and upper class women lived and traveled separately from men on board steamships in the 1830s. The women's cabin was private. Social mores did not allow men to enter unless specifically invited. This cabin was also more luxurious than that of their male counterparts. Middle and upper class women had more amenities in their staterooms in order to make traveling more agreeable. These amenities included such diverse items as a porte and special basins for washing. Nevertheless, several passengers noted and interpreted that daily life on the upper deck was hot. Social custom pressed these women to spend most of their time in the person, writing letters or reading. Mrs. Basil Hall wrote, "We all sit in our respective cars and read our books and write the letters without seeming to know that there are other occupants in the cabin as well." When the staterooms got too high, being both above the fire and the roof, and being for all the army,
found myself on board of the Sawyer boat, whether at dinner or company, Sunday, June 5th. Reverend and Grant and Ross later on the way to my place. Past the day, the Arkansas Maryland Airlines is today is Valentine's Day. And this is the first day of the year. My wife is still with your friends. About 8 o'clock, passed the celebrated cave and rock, of which we had a full view. The scenery was truly splendid. 9 o'clock, met and passed the steamboat farmer, supposedly.